And I request our Honorable Vice Chancellor to chair the session. And I also request, today we have the guest of honor, Professor Sissy Roy. And also we have guest, Professor S.R. Bhatt. Professor S.R. Bhattji. Yeah, Professor S.R. Bhattji, please come on the dais. Friends, since last 2 days, we had this seminar, and we had 28 papers, one absent, which was a female arhata in Buddhism by Dr. Karma Sonam Palmo. She was due to some health reasons, she couldn't come. At last, she dropped. Mitro, हमारे दो दिन से ये संगोष्ठी चल रही है और आज ये तीसरा दिन है समाप्ति का अंतिम सत्र है हमारे इस इन दो दिनों में दो और आज आधा दिन ढाई दिनों में आठ सत्र हुए आठ सत्रों में 28 पेपर्स पढ़े गए जिसमें एक पेपर एक हमारे स्कॉलर जो है अनुपस्थित रहीं उनका पेपर था फीमेल अर्हत इन बुद्धिज्म इन सत्रों में और क्योंकि बुद्धिस्ट बौद्ध अध्ययन के विषय पर हम लोगों ने करीब करीब हमने सभी विषयों को छुआ इसमें हमने मेथोडोलॉजी प्रतीत समुत्पाद थेरावाद में और महायान में और 37 बोधिपाक्षिक धर्म थेरावाद के अनुसार और महायान के अनुसार महासती पट्टवायन पर समत विपश्यना थेरावाद और महायान के संदर्भ में संस्कृत पांडुलिपियों पर और ट्रांसलेशंस ऑफ बुद्धिस्ट संस्कृत टेक्स्ट अंबेडकर जी के कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ जस्टिस इन बुद्धिज्म वज्रयाना सिस्टम ऑफ बुद्धिज्म और विज्ञानवाद के थ्री नेचर तीन स्वभाव इन सभी विषयों इसके अतिरिक्त भी अनेक आर्ट अजंता आर्ट और हमने सामाजिक और अन्य विषयों पर भी यहाँ पेपर प्रस्तुत किए गए बहुत अच्छा रहा प्रश्न खूब प्रश्न हुए समय की सीमा को नज़र रखते हुए हमें प्रश्नों को कम करना पड़ा जिसके लिए हम आप लोगों से माफ़ी चाहते हैं और लेकिन कुल मिलाकर हम सफल हमने एक हमारा यह सफल आयोजन रहा और आज के हमारे अंतिम वैलिडेटरी सेशन के अध्यक्ष कर रहे हैं हमारे माननीय वाइस चांसलर प्रोफेसर केशवगांव समदन जी विशिष्ट अतिथि के रूप में हमारे बीच में उपस्थित हैं प्रोफेसर शिशि रॉय और मुख्य अतिथि के रूप में एस आर भट्ट जी मंच पर आसीन हैं मैं अब आगे इस कार्यक्रम को आगे बढ़ाते हुए हमारे जो प्रतिभागी हैं इसके बीच से जो दो ढाई दिनों का जो हमारा अनुभव रहा जो कार्यक्रम हम लोगों ने किए उसके 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 बारे में अपने विचार और अपने अनुभव को यहाँ रखने के लिए मैं तीन विद्वानों को बुलाना चाहूँगा एक एक करके सबसे मैं उनका समय की सीमा को ध्यान में रखते हुए 5 मिनट का समय है उसमें अपने को बांधने का कष्ट कीजिएगा प्रोफेसर मधुमिता चट्टोपाध्याय आप जादवपुर यूनिवर्सिटी से हैं सर्वप्रथम आप आएंगी और अपना अनुभव रखेंगी
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी आई हैव बीन रिक्वेस्टेड बाय द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स ऑफ दिस नेशनल सेमिनार ऑन बुद्ध स्टडीज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय द CIHTS टू शेयर माय एक्सपीरियंसेस हियर एज अ पार्टिसिपेंट As we all know, this seminar is actually a part of the year-long academic programs undertaken by this esteemed institute to celebrate its Golden Jubilee. This Golden Jubilee celebration actually started with the organization of an international seminar with the blessings of His Holiness 14th Dalai Lama. Such sort of academic feasts can be organized only by such centers as CIHTS. I personally am grateful to Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Samtenji for giving me the chance to participate in both the conferences and quench my thirst for learning different areas of Buddhist philosophy. The present seminar is less glamorous in comparison to the earlier one in respect of its status. The former was an international one, and the present being national. Though a national one, this seminar is unique in one respect, namely its topic. Apparently, the title of this three-day seminar seems to be vague. Simple Buddhist studies seems to be lacking a focus. But the organizers, I believe, are very careful and wise. By selecting such a title, they wanted to present before the world the vastness of the scope of doing researches on Buddhism. Buddhism, though to the world, is popular as a religion, giving emphasis on peace and nonviolence, spreading the messages of compassion and friendliness. A deep study into its literature reveals that it is a mine of several unnoticed ayahs under which, several unnoticed ayahs, which if digged out and polished properly through rational deliberations and studies, can shine like jewels. And it is not possible for a single person to study all these aspects in one's lifetime. The organizers have made a great effort to present before us the important areas of Buddhist studies, namely Buddhist philosophy, Buddhist literature, with the emphasis on textual studies, where the methodology of how the transliteration of lost Buddhist texts of other languages to Sanskrit can be done, practical aspects of Buddhism, which nowadays is known as engaged Buddhism, Buddhist art and architecture, and last but not the least, the area of Buddhism and science. The different sessions of the seminar have been arranged accordingly, and most of the 27 papers nicely circulated beforehand so that the participants can have beforehand a view of what is going to be discussed and prepare himself or herself accordingly. So in one word, the academic side of the conference is very well organized. So for the intellectual side, the organizers have not ignored the mundane aspect of the mundane side of the participants also. They have kept keen eyes on the daily needs of each and every participant. Starting from serving bed tea in early morning till nice dinner at 9 o'clock, they have left no stone unturned to make our stay here comfortable. We are given the facilities of a 5-star hotel, but with a touch of love and care, thus making our stay here a wonderful one. And I myself always look forward to coming here again and again. It is a sort of homecoming for me. In short, the whole seminar, in my opinion, is a grand success, and I would like to thank the organizers and the authority of the CIHTS for what they have done. Thank you.
धन्यवाद. हम लोगों ने इसको क्या कहते हैं कि तीन श्रेणियों में बांट करके, एक सीनियर वरिष्ठ वर्ग और दूसरा युवा वर्ग और तीसरा जो है रिसर्च स्कॉलर के रूप में, इस प्रकार से हमने एक प्रतिनिधि के रूप में आपके सामने सीनियर वरिष्ठ विद्वानों के प्रतिनिधि के रूप में प्रोफेसर मधुमिता चट्टोपाध्याय ने अपने विचार व्यक्त किए. इसके बाद में युवा वर्ग के प्रतिनिधि के रूप में डॉक्टर लोबसांग सुरडिम भुटिया CIBS लेह लद्दाख से को उनको आमंत्रित करता हूं कि वह अपने अनुभव और अपने विचार यहाँ रखें.
रिस्पेक्टेड चेयरपर्सन ऑफ दिस वैलेडिक्टरी सेशन, द वाइस चांसलर ऑफ दिस इंस्टीट्यूट प्रोफेसर गेशे वांगसंतेन जी एंड स्कॉलर्स ऑन द डायस एंड द डिग्निटरीज ऑफ द डायस हु केम फ्रॉम द वेरियस इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड द स्टूडेंट कंसर्न ऑफ दिस इंस्टीट्यूट. Yesterday, I was asked to share something about my experience in the last 2 days. Yeah, in this seminar, what I gained, what I have seen in this seminar. So, in this seminar, when I received the invitation from the organizing committee, first I was asked to to sketch my research paper on the two truth. And later, after 10 days, and the organizer, the member of organizer committee has again said me that to write on the Vajrayana system of Buddhism. But when I got an invitation during that time, the seminar is on the topic of Buddhist study. So when I saw the invitation letter and the concept note, in that concept note, it is clearly mentioned that the organizer committee has a shape or structure the Buddhist study in a four form. So this is very interesting for me. The first one is in a philosophical section. In the philosophic Buddhist philosophy section, they have given a subtopic like philosophy and practice of 37 Pratipagya Dhamma in Theraveda, philosophy and practice of 37 Pratipakshya Dharma in Mahayana, and presentation of true truth according to Vaibhashika and Sotrantika, presentation of three characteristics according to Vinayavad, philosophy and Pratityasamutpada, philosophy of Pratityasamutpada, the nature of Samatha, Vipassana and afflicted obstruction in Theraveda, the nature of Samatha, Vipassana and afflicted obstruction in Mahayana. This is the part of the core part of, I think, the Buddhist study, because it covers all the philosophy aspect of this study. And the next, in this Buddhist study, the next, the major topic is on the Buddhist literature. In Buddhist literature, such as the topic was given, the comparative study of translation of Sanskrit texts, Buddhist manuscript, philological study of Buddhist texts. And the fourth, the major point, was on the engaged Buddhism. It has a subtopic such as Buddhism ethic, Buddhism social justice, Buddhism environment, ecology, Buddhism and art of living, Buddhism and gender, relevance of Buddhism in modern era. And the third one, the fourth one, is on, as a major topic of this study is on Buddhist art and architecture. It has a subtopic such as art and architecture of Buddhist stupa and scripture, early Buddhist iconography, Buddhist symbolic arts and their significance, parameters of Buddhist art. And the fifth one is Buddhism and science, Buddhism and psychology. It is the mostly based on the comparative major, Buddhism and parapsychology, Buddhism and quantum physics, Buddhism and social science, Buddhism and neuroscience. So when I, in the last 2 days, when I interact, when I listen from the speakers, from the who came from the different institution, so upon hearing this the lectures on this topic, I felt that Buddhist study or the Buddhology should become into this sort of, you know, the subtopic. So I feel very happy, and in the, you know, various technical session, the many speaker has given their own perspective, and also the paper, which is very very unique for me, and the most important is that it opened my the door of horizon to how to understand the Buddhist study through this sort of topic. So for me, I got lots of benefits, and at the same time, I would like to say one thing. I want to share something about that. I am the product of this institute. So because this is my parental institute, and during my student time, and also I worked here for 3 years, 4 years. During that time, every part of the institute, whether it is a teachers and a student and all the administrative, you know, the member, they have supported me, nurtured me, guided me a lot. For them, you know, I thank you all from my heart. And at the same time, I'd like to just want to say, This is for the student of this institute, that in the academic world, we learn mostly about the, you know, especially here in this institute, we learn mostly about the Mahayana tradition. It is good, but we are learning through the academic, you know, conversation, academic, you know, academic sort of activity. So I think it is good, but only academic activity, if you go if you go through this academic activity, then I think it will give you some sort of slight understanding about the, it will generate, it will develop the mental development. But in order to understand the Buddhism, especially the Mahayana Buddhism, holistically, I think that the meditation is very important, because this is only for my only for the student. Meditation is the one of the biggest study part of the Buddhism, because according to Buddhism, there are specific Buddhist study concept is that first we have to hear, and then we have to reflect, and then after that, it should be concluded in by doing meditation. So why it is very important doing meditation is that, because when we do meditation, meditation means that whatever you hear, whatever you, you know, reflect, so that reflection, that conclusion should be, should, you know, connect with the emotion. This is the first stage of meditation. If you do not connect with your emotion, then I think all the learning process will go in vain. So I think for the student, if you do a one single moment of meditation in your life during your student life, then I think this all the Buddhist study will become very helpful tools in your coming life. So with this note, I will conclude here. And at last, I like to say convey my thankfulness to organizing committee and all the working committee for giving their good hospitality. And with this, thank you very much.
हम भी यही चाहते थे कि हमारा युवा वर्ग आगे आए, अपनी जिज्ञासा को बढ़ाएं और उस पर यहाँ विचार विमर्श करें और यहाँ से लाभान्वित होकर आगे बढ़ें और उन्नति करें. और जैसे अभी हमारे भूटिया जी ने कहा कि बुद्धिज़्म में साधना बहुत ज़रूरी है, श्रवण मनन और चिंतन, ये तीन प्रोसेस बहुत ही ज़रूरी हैं. बिना श्रवण के आपको क्या कहते हैं ज्ञान का, ज्ञान नहीं मिलेगा, ज्ञान समझ में नहीं आएगा. और जब श्रवण और श्रवण का जब हम जब तक चिंतन नहीं करेंगे, तब तक वो श्रवण जो है वो हमारी पुष्ट नहीं होगी, चरितार्थ नहीं होगी. विचारिते विचारयेतु विचारस्य अस्ति नाश्रयः नाश्रित्वाद् नो उदेति तच्च निर्वाणम् उच्यते करके. तो चिंतन जरूरी है, और जब चिंतन पराकाष्ठा पर पहुँच जाए तो मनन अपने आप ही आ जाता है. तो इसलिए अपनी जिज्ञासा को बनाए रखे और उसका उत्तरोत्तर विकास कीजिए. हम युवा वर्ग से ये आशा करते हैं कि आगे बढ़ करके आप लोगों को ही ये परंपरा संभालनी है, ये विरासत आप लोगों को संभालनी है, ये धरोहर आपके हाथ में है. मैं अब तीसरे जो हमारे और भी इससे भी जो युवा वर्ग अभी जो आने वाली पीढ़ी है, रिसर्च शोध छात्रों के प्रतिनिधि के रूप में समरजीत कौर को, जो दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी में रिसर्च स्कॉलर हैं, उनको बुलाना चाहता हूँ. वो आए और अपने अनुभव और अपने विचार यहाँ रखें.
ऑनरेबल चेयरमैन, यूबीसी ऑफ सेंट्रल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ हायर टिबेटन स्टडीज, डिस्टिंग्विश्ड स्कॉलर्स एंड अगस्त गैदरिंग्स, आई एम थैंकफुल टू दिस एस्टीम्ड इंस्टीट्यूशन फॉर नॉट ओनली इन्वाइटिंग मी टू पार्टिसिपेट इन दिस ब्यूटिफुली ऑर्गेनाइज्ड सेमिनार, but also for providing opportunity to the younger scholars like me to share the experience we had during these 3 days. My experience is not differentiated or different than the previous 2 shared experiences. And I would like to add that having been attended various conferences and seminars till date, I found the atmosphere of this seminar to be very conducive and productive, which not only sowed the seeds of curiosity, but has also encouraged to take active participation in all the papers presented. Interestingly, all the papers being presented dealt with various aspects of Buddhism from micro to macro level within the span of 3 days. As I'm pursuing PhD in Delhi University, and as the Buddha said, that analyze and synthesize. So what I believe that micro and macro level analysis and its synthesis would be a really helping aid for me to continue my better version of writing PhD, as it's all about relation of environment and us. It's about Niyam, the regulator of cosmos. And all the papers were very brilliant, and among the notable were, which I felt, Tri Swabhav of Yogachar Vigyanvad, Abhidham ke Udbhav ke Mooladhar Dhamchak Pavattan Sutra, Buddha in the Arts of Ajanta, the Concept of Justice in Buddhism, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar's Perspective, Two Truths, and especially the Quantum Entanglement and Metaphysics Relations. This is kind and certain more points like discussion which happened on Hetu, Pratyay, Pachay, Pathan, and relationary approach towards everything is has given me a stimulating factor to write the conclusion sitting in this place itself. And last but not the least, I would like to say that this institution would continue to convene such kind of thought-provoking seminars in future as well for the benefit of all. The Buddha said, Bhaujan Hitai, Bhaujan Sukai. Indeed, it was the wonderful experience. Thank you so much.
Dhanyavad, Sumarjit Kaur. Now, iske baad main hamare manchast, हमारे विशिष्ट अतिथि प्रोफेसर शिशिर रॉय जो साइंटिस्ट हैं और प्रथम दिन से ही मैं उनको देख रहा हूं कि वो सारे सत्रों में उपस्थित रहे और कल भी बड़े चाव से वो सभी पेपरों को सुनते रहे. मैंने उनको बड़ी रुचि लेते हुए देखा, बड़ी खुशी हुई, बहुत अच्छा भी लगा और एक उत्साह भी मिला, उनसे प्रेरणा भी मिली. तो मैं आपसे विनम्र निवेदन करता हूँ, क्योंकि समय का अभाव है, मैं इसलिए ज़्यादा नहीं कह रहा हूँ. मैं आपसे अनुरोध करता हूँ कि इस अंतिम सत्र में, समापन सत्र में अपना उद्बोधन प्रस्तुत करें.
गुड आफ्टरनून ऑनरेबल चेयरमैन ऑफ वैलेडिक्टरी सेशन प्रोफेसर के सी शमतनी एंड Chief guest, Professor Ishar Bhatt, and my colleagues. I have the opportunity to attend the first international conference for this Golden Jubilee celebration when His Holiness 14th Dalai Lama was himself present. And that was international seminar, and there are also the session on Buddhism and science. It was in greater scale. Every time when I think that His Holiness has deep interest in science, like when he came from Tibet to India, one of the very few things which he brought with him, the telescope. So he, from that age, he was so much interested in science, and later with the Life and Mind Institute, they arrange almost every alternate year different branches of science and interactions with Buddhist scholars and Buddhist philosophy. But the problem, with the encouragement of ICPR, we are also arrange some of the workshop for the students. The first problem is that in this country, it's really have
a good number of students because of the global technological revolutions. The students are mainly interested in technology, information technology, and they are not really much interested in studying any kind of philosophy, including Buddhist one. His Holiness took an initiative, of course, but the thing which intrigued me for many, many years, that why we are not able to bring the young minds in this kind of conference. Even I have some bright students who are now occupying different faculty positions in various institutes and university. When I talk to them also, they ask me very simple questions. If we attend or participate in this kind of conference, can we get some insights which will help in our own studies, own research? This is very, very difficult, though simple questions. And still, I don't know the right answer for that. We need to create a proper environment that really, if you study Buddhist philosophy and, of course, other Indian philosophical schools, how it will help developing their own ideas. Once the famous physicist Heisenberg, he was giving a talk in an international conference that that time he was a professor of theoretical physics. So he told, I came to this international conference, where discussions of epistemological issues and philosophical issues are discussed, as a professor of theoretical physics. They are paying me the salary for doing theoretical physics. So have I come here just as my hobby, or really the ancient wisdom, in his sense, the Greek wisdom, will help me a lot? This question was raised by even another famous scientist, Erwin Schrödinger, who was one of the fathers of quantum theory. But we need to create really environment. And also, there is a difference in methodology between science and philosophy. Like in science, we do believe in empiricism, and in philosophy, we call introspections. So, and experience. So, we scientists really don't know what is introspection, in which way it will help us, though experience also plays a great role in discovery of many, many fundamental things. So my suggestion here, whether we can arrange even in a smaller scale some of the workshops type things, where we can explain the basic things, basic concepts in Buddhist philosophy to more and more younger people. Because people might say that you guys, you are going to be retired soon, or you have retired, you don't have to do anything, you are doing Buddhism or Vedantin or any kinds of things. But we need to kind of take an initiative so that more and more young minds will come. And here I am really glad that a sizable number of students are participating here, and they are interacting. Even in science, I saw they have a lot of interest. So hope this institute has a great role in arranging many such good conferences. They will arrange this kind of workshop or small seminars so that we can really form a platform for future generations. Thank you.
Dhanyavad, Professor Shishir Roy ji. मैं अब आज के चीफ गेस्ट प्रोफेसर एस आर हमारे मुख्य अतिथि प्रोफेसर एस आर भट्ट जी से निवेदन करता हूं कि वे अपना उद्बोधन प्रस्तुत करें.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Namang Samtenji, Professor Sushil Roy, and distinguished delegates to this seminar. I am really happy and feel privileged to partake in the concluding session of this seminar. I had the good fortune of being associated with this August Institute right from its very inception, when Honorable Professor Samdong Rinpoche ji was the principal of a school here. It started with a school. And along with him and late Professor Jagannath ji Upadhyay, we used to have such seminars. Later on, of course, it took the shape of a university, and we also had a very seminar under the stewardship of Professor Rinpoche ji. And Professor Samtenji is also equally active, energetic, and has a vision to advance Buddhist studies in this institution. Buddhist studies is multifaceted, and therefore it has different areas of studies. Buddhism has been a most significant facet of Indian culture, which has originated in India and spread now almost all over the world, contributing significantly to world thought and culture. So Buddhism is at once both ancient as well as modern and contemporary. In fact, it has some seminal ideas, doctrines, and theories which can contribute quite a lot for paradigm shifts in modes of thinking and ways of living of the entire globe. It has that potentiality, and that potentiality needs to be explored. I am also associated with the Indian Council of Philosophical Research and a wing of Ministry of Human Resource Development, and we are trying our best to organize seminars and workshops, particularly workshops for studying threadbare the Buddhist texts, particularly the text in the field of philosophy. We find that there is a good response from young scholars to study Buddhism. But we are handicapped so far as resource persons are concerned, who can meaningfully handle their texts. I therefore request that scholars should come forward to study the text and teach the text to the younger generation. Say, for example, we had very good workshops on Pramana Samuchaya, but then through secondary sources only, we couldn't get first-hand acquaintance with the text. But Nyaya Bindu we had, and Nyaya Bindu is easily available. I wish that we should study Hetu Chakra Daburu of the Naga, which has tremendous potentialities to offer a formal system of logic, which is unique in Buddhism. We wanted to have a workshop on Vigraha Vyavartini, which is the basis of Mula Madhyamika Karika, but we couldn't get good resource persons for that. And we are still waiting for holding that particular workshop. The point is this, that we have many seminal texts like Ratnakirti Nibandhavali, or we have many such texts which need our serious scrutiny, attention, and teaching. And I hope that this institute will undertake their. Buddhism is known for its philosophy, which is foundational. Other areas are, of course, offshoots. So the Buddhist philosophy needs serious attention and study. Buddhist texts are really very much intricate and sophisticated. And their subtleties needs to be explored. The type of thinking that has gone into, for example, in the works of Vasubandhu, let alone the Pali literature. Pali literature is also very rich, very profound. But later on, the works of Vasubandhu, Dinnag, Dharmakirti, etc. in one tradition, Asanga and Maitreya in another tradition, I think we have a very rich literature. And it demands a serious study. So I wish that this particular institute can take all these facets of Buddhistic learning. And I'm happy to note that 27 papers were presented in this seminar. I could not be present here because of my engagement in another seminar elsewhere. But I feel that this seminar was a grand success, and credit goes to the vision of Honorable Vice Chancellor and our Dorji ji also took good initiative. And I feel that this sort of activities should continue to be organized in this prestigious institute for welfare of the whole humanity, because Lord Buddha advised Charita Bhikkhave Charikam Bahujan Hitaya Bahujan Sukhaya. Let whole humanity be benefited by Buddhistic learning, and it is really meaningful and profound. Whenever we organize such Jnana Yajna, there are two objectives. One is the prayojana. What for and why for we organize this thing. And I hope that the prayojana has been achieved in this particular seminar. And the other is phala, the outcome. I think that the outcome also has been quite splendid. And this prayojana and phala should get disseminated, and this was a point raised by one of the participants that there should be a tangible outcome of it. And I hope that the papers presented here will see the light of the day in a proper revised form, because after deliberation, the paper writers may think of revising them so that they reach to different parts of the world, and in a published form, of course, and people may get benefit out of that. So I'm once again express my gratefulness to Professor Semten, Professor Dorji, and other organizers of this prestigious seminar. Thank you very much.
धन्यवाद प्रोफेसर एस आर भट्ट जी, आप हमारे उद्घाटन सत्र में पधारे और आपने हमको अपने आशीर्वचन से हमें लाभान्वित किया। अब मैं कंक्लूडिंग रिमार्क्स के लिए हमारे ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर प्रोफेसर गेशेंगाओ समदेन जी, केंद्रीय उच्च तिब्बती शिक्षा संस्थान से निवेदन करता हूँ कि वे अपना उद्बोधन।
पूज्य भिक्षु संघ, respected Professor S.R. Bhatt Saab, revered Professor C.C. Roy ji, distinguished scholars, and friends, and my dear students. In the beginning, we thought about including some more subjects and covering more areas, but that was not possible. Because as many have observed that Buddhism is a very vast subject, and it covers a huge spectrum of subjects and areas. So in order to give a flavor, initially, what should be the name of the conference, or on what topic we should convene the conference? Should it be Buddhist philosophy, Buddhist spirituality, or what kind of, you know, Buddhist schools or Buddhist traditions or things like that? Then Buddhist studies, we thought that Buddhist studies would be good, since that would include a wide range of, you know, subjects. And at present, we in India need to focus on making our centers, making our departments, study centers stronger, and make them more serious, and make them really hub of intellectual kind of, you know, study, and where they can attract scholars from within the country as well as from outside the country. Because now these days, not only the government-funded institutions, but also many of the private universities are coming up with the programs and departments of Buddhist studies. And many of the government-funded institutions, of course, are also coming up with, you know, the Buddhist studies department. So I once expressed this idea somewhere way back, but I thought I should repeat it here today. In front of India, we have an excellent example, and we are the holder of the lineage of those great traditions of ancient India, Nalanda, Vikramashila, Takshashila. And what better example can we have than those great, you know, the institutions. And then after that, it went to different other countries. In China, it went for the first time to Sri Lanka, and then to China, and then to Tibet. And the way Buddhism went to China was more on the individual choice basis and individual interest based. But whereas the Buddhism in Tibet was in a very different manner. It was very well planned, well organized, and it was funded by the government of that time, the country, and under such a kind of system that the best of the best Indian masters were invited to Tibet, not only few dozens, but in hundreds number, the best of the best, the cream of the cream scholars and the practitioners were invited. And in the same manner, thousands of students, the best students, were sent to India to study in Nalanda, Vikramashila, Takshashila, Odandapuri, and those places. As a result, we have such intensive and very profound Buddhism imported from India, and the tradition also was brought in Tibet. So that is how we have a very intensive high level of intellectual exercise and very deep, profound study of philosophy, and very wide range of studies in not only just Buddhism but also in different other areas as well, which were prevalent and which were brought from Nalanda. And now the third example we have is the Western countries, Western universities. They have taken up Buddhism earlier, prior to 40 years back. There were very selected universities who have taken up Buddhist studies. But in the last 40 years, many of the universities and colleges have taken up Buddhist studies. And the scholars are engaged in very serious studies in Harvard, in Cambridge, in Columbia, in Virginia, in Wisconsin, to name out, you know, some of the universities in the United States, and then in Australia, in Canada, in European, you know, countries. There are so many universities who are engaged seriously, and they are bringing up books, not only translations. Now, so far, I think more than 1,000 treatises of the works of Indian, the teachings of the Buddha and works of Indian masters and the Tibetan masters have been translated into, already available in English language and French, German, Italian, and other languages. And on the top of that, many scholars have written independent research, you know, books as a product of their research, very serious, high level of, you know, high quality research works they have done. So we have those things. Now we need to, you know, expedite our exercises. And one thing is that, as I was earlier, you know, raising this voice, that in India, when we have Buddhist studies only at the master level, then what happens? Only at the master level, students start studying Buddhism. Whereas at the master level, students should be at the master's level in terms of their, you know, knowledge. But when they reach, when they are at the master level, they take, you know, they opt Buddhist studies and then study some Dhammapada shlokas and some very basic texts. And then after that, when they do research, then you can understand what would be the level of research. So therefore, I think at the master's level, as well as at the bachelor's level, we must have a substantial kind of curriculum so that they may be, you know, when they reach to the master's level, they are well-versed in Buddhist philosophy, they are well-grounded in Buddhist philosophy, and then after that, they can jump into, research. And then post-research works are also, you know, we need to create research projects and things like that so that we can have more serious and more, you know, with the higher level of works and researches done in this country. Because this is the origin of Buddhist philosophy and all of these precious, you know, great traditions. And we must have a more serious kind of, you know, of course, we do have many individual scholars and a few institutions, but that is not sufficient. We need much more to be engaging into these exercises. So therefore, it is a kind of pain that we, you know, express occasionally. And in the last 10 years, I think we have made in various places some improvement, but that improvement is not sufficient. And many of our authorities and many of our agencies and the granting agencies like the Indian Council of Philosophical Research, since Professor Bharti took, he has been taking initiatives in conducting workshops and seminars and things like that in order to promote better understanding of Buddhist philosophy and other philosophies, of course. So when we have, since we have this very rich tradition, we must promote it and then try to revive this. This institute, with its very minuscule and very humble manner, have started the ancient tradition of interaction between Buddhist and the non-Buddhist Indian philosophical schools. As a very small, you know, kind of contribution, we started having some conferences and workshops, inviting scholars from Vedanta, from Sankhya, from Vaisheshik, Nyaya, and from Jaina. And as you know, we did last time at the beginning of this Golden Jubilee, we invited scholars, in which you also took, you both were there, and modern science also, you know, participated. So now we have in front of us the ancient Indian traditional philosophical schools, and then we have modern science, and on the top of that we have you know, Western philosophy to interact with. So there is a wide range of kind of, you know, the traditions and areas with whom we can have, we must have interaction. So therefore, our attempt is to, you know, by organizing this conference, we can just simply send the message that Buddhism has a very wide, you know, range of kind of interest in its exploration of reality. So therefore, now, as one of our revered scholar mentioned in the last technical session, that some waves were created. That is the purpose of this. I'm happy that that wave has been felt by somebody, and this has been the purpose. So our purpose is to create some wave, and then this wave should not be confined after the boundary of this institute, but this wave should go away with all of you. The wave is not a physical wave, it's a mental wave, intellectual wave that should go with your mind. And then this wave should again create some ripples in your individual departments and universities, so that we can have a wider range of, you know, ripples and waves. And then once this wave transforms into a major, you know, tide, then we can feel the transformation at the national level in a more kind of substantive manner. So this was the purpose of organizing this conference. So I'm very happy that you know, the many scholars have expressed, although I wanted to attend most of the conference, the sessions, but due to many other engagements, I could not. But when I heard from the scholars, they either diplomatically or in reality express their, you know, satisfaction in terms of the presentation of the papers, and they have heard. So I'm happy that it has served some purpose in order to provoke you and in order to create a wave that we, that you can go to your respective institutions and start something, so that later we can, you know, join again. And at some place, not necessarily here, sometimes it could be here, but sometimes it could be some at some other places where we can work together, and then, you know, move further in order to promote. Because Buddhist study, we should not confine it just simply to, you know, some specific texts. As I said in the beginning, in the inaugural session, that it's a very, you know, comprehensive. So it can interact with the modern subjects like political science, economics. Already economics and political science are, scientists are interacting with Buddhism. Because in economics there is, you know, the little is beautiful, small is beautiful, and the altruistic economy, these are being conceived. And not only conceived, these are becoming already, they have taken shape of becoming a part of the national economy policy. So these are something that we can contribute, and of course with the Western science, Western philosophy, and then with the, you know, modern science. So there are so many areas, almost with all these, you know, areas of studies, there are rooms and spaces for Buddhism to interact, and so that to which Buddhism can make a, you know, substantial contribution. So therefore, now we should be prepared, mentally prepared, not confining to our, in, you know, regular kind of shell, but to come out of the shell and then, you know, expand yourself and then expand and interact and contribute to the to other, you know, the fields. So with these words, I would like to thank our Professor S.R. Bhatji and Professor C.C. Royji and all the distinguished scholars and the senior Professor Satipalji and many of you and particularly the young scholars and our students who have participated. Why we have organized this in the larger hall is in order to provide rooms for more students to participate. Otherwise, we could have arranged it in a more warmer, you know, smaller room, which could be more warmer, right? So, but to organize this in a larger is to provide opportunity for more students. And I'm happy that many of the students have also participated. And I would like to thank our organizing committee who have, the members have worked tirelessly. And then also I would like to thank the members of all the committees. We have transportation committee, we have the catering committee, we have logistic committee, we have many other committees. And then I would like to thank our gardeners who have been looking after the gardens and then, you know, making the, decorating the hall and then making arrangements in beautiful arrangements and looking after the gardens. So with these, I would like to thank everybody and wish you to take with you the ripples and the waves and please don't leave the waves behind. Thank you very much.
बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद ऑनरेबल कुलपति महोदय ने बहुत ही विस्तार से संगोष्ठी के नामकरण इसकी संरचना इसके विषयों के बारे में चयन के बारे में और विद्वानों के आमंत्रण के चयन के बारे में और इसके जो उद्देश्य हैं प्रयोजन हैं उसके बारे में और इतना ही नहीं जो बौद्ध अध्ययन आज विश्व में पाश्चात्य जगत में फैल रहा है और यूनिवर्सिटियों में और भारत में भी धीरे धीरे सभी यूनिवर्सिटियों में इसके डिपार्टमेंट खुल रहे हैं इनके बारे में सूचनाएं और जो इसके बारे में जो योजनाएं हैं इनके बारे में आपने हमें हमारा ज्ञान बढ़ाया हमें बहुत महत्वपूर्ण सूचनाएँ दी अब आपने हम लोगों का जो आयोजन समिति है उसका एक जो अंतिम कार्य होता है एक औपचारिकता जिसको हम धन्यवाद के रूप में कहते हैं बहुत का बहुत सारा कार्य तो आपने कर दिया धन्यवाद दे करके लेकिन फिर भी क्योंकि आयोजन समिति का अपना एक दायित्व तो है कि आए हुए सभी प्रतिभागियों और जो जितने भी यहाँ अतिथिगण सब आए हैं उनके लिए और जितने भी हमारे इस आयोजन को सफल बनाने में कार्यकर्ता जो परोक्ष प्रत्यक्ष और परोक्ष रूप से जो सदस्य रहे हैं जिन्होंने प्रतिभाग की है जिन्होंने सहयोग किया है उनको धन्यवाद देने का अंत में तो मैं हमारे प्रोफेसर पेम्बादुर जी जी हमारे आयोजक मंडल के समिति के सदस्य आपको आपसे निवेदन आमंत्रित करता हूँ यहाँ धन्यवाद ज्ञापन करने के लिए
पूज्य भिक्षु संघ इस समापन समारोह के अध्यक्ष माननीय कुलपति महोदय मुख्य अतिथि प्रोफेसर एस आर भट्ट साहब विशेष अतिथि प्रोफेसर शिशिर घोष जी और सभी डेलीगेट्स और छात्रों अब मैं यहाँ इस तीन दिवसीय संगोष्ठी की अंतिम चरण की धन्यवाद ज्ञापन के लिए यहाँ खड़ा हूँ ये एक औपचारिकता है फिर भी उसको निभाना बहुत ज़रूरी है मैं सबसे पहले वरिष्ठ प्रोफेसर श्री शिशिर घोष जी का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ क्योंकि मैंने जब हमारे कुलपति जी के निर्देश अनुसार हमने जब ईमेल्स या चिट्ठी भेजना शुरू किया था तो सबसे पहले प्रोफेसर शिशिर घोष जी ने जवाब दिया कि हम आएंगे, तो इससे हमें एक बल मिला कि मैं तो ये, हम तो पहले ये उम्मीद कर रहे थे कि हमारे बुद्धिस्ट स्टडीज़ के लोग सबसे पहले हमें जवाब देंगे, लेकिन किसी साइंटिस्ट ने हमें जवाब दिया, तो इसके लिए हमको एक बल मिला कि हाँ ये सेमिनार कुछ होने वाला है। तो इसलिए मैं आपके बहुत बहुत आभारी हूँ, थैंक यू सो मच। और इसके बाद हमारे वरिष्ठतम प्रोफेसर श्री एस आर भट्ट जी का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा कि आपको हमने पहले सेमिनार के लिए निमंत्रण भेजा था, आपने कहा कि ठीक है मैं आ जाऊँगा, मेरे पास सिर्फ एक ही दिन है, तो इस एक दिन में आप मुझे जहाँ भी बिठाएं मैं बैठूँगा। तो उसके बाद फिर मैंने कहा आप आ ही रहे हैं तो इस समापन समारोह के मुख्य अतिथि बनने के लिए हम अनुरोध करते हैं, तो कहते हैं ठीक है मैं करूँगा। तो इसलिए मैं आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। इसके साथ साथ अब हमारे यहाँ हम लोगों ने सबसे पहले करीब 60 लोगों को हम लोगों ने निमंत्रण भेजा था, लेकिन अंत में हमारे पास सिर्फ 32 लोगों ने अपना स्वीकृति दिए। उनमें से जैसे कि प्रोफेसर गोगले जी है हमारे, प्रोफेसर सत्यपाल जी है, और प्रोफेसर मधुमिता जी है, कुंतला जी है, प्रवीण जी है, एम एस दास जी है, और प्रोफेसर हमारे संस्कृत यूनिवर्सिटी के प्रोफेसर अधिकारी जी है, रमेश प्रसाद जी है, और आरंज प्रसाद जी जो नालंदा से है, और इन सब लोगों ने जो हमारे जो सीनियर प्रोफेसर्स हैं सब ने हमारे निमंत्रण को स्वीकार करके यहाँ अपना व्यस्तम कार्यक्रम में से समय निकाल कर यहाँ आया है और अपने पेपर प्रेजेंट किया है, उसके लिए मैं तहे दिल से शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहूँगा। और इसके साथ साथ जैसे पेमा जी ने भी कहा था कि हमारे युवा पीढ़ी के जो कई प्रोफेसर्स अभी हमारे यहाँ से भी निकले हुए हैं, कई दूसरे जगह से भी निकले हुए हैं, उन्होंने भी इसमें भाग लेकर अपना प्रेजेंटेशन दिया है, उन सबको भी मैं धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। और इसके साथ साथ हमारे कुलपति जी का निर्देश ये रहा कि इसमें हमारे ऑब्जर्वर पार्टिसिपेंट ज़्यादा होना चाहिए, जो युवा अभी रिसर्च कर रहे हो और युवा या रिसर्च करने वाले हो, उन सबको भी हमको निर्देश दिया कि उनको ज़रूर इसमें शामिल करना चाहिए। तो उनके निर्देश अनुसार हमने कई लोगों को दिया, तो काफ़ी लोगों ने इसमें भाग लिया है, उन सब पर मैं धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। और आप सब के वजह से ये मैं नहीं कह रहा हूँ, आप लोग कह रहे हैं कि ये संगोष्ठी सफल रहा, उसके लिए मैं आप संयोजकों की ओर से हम सब क्या हमारे जो मेहनत जो है वो सफल रहा, इसलिए हम अपने आप को भी धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। अब इसके साथ साथ जो हमारे इस संगोष्ठी के जो हम लोग 4-5 लोग एक ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कमेटी के तौर पर है, लेकिन हमारे आंख, हमारे पैर, हमारे हाथ, तो बाकी जो कमेटी हैं वही लोग हैं, इन्होंने अपने पूरे तत्परता से इस संगोष्ठी को सफल बनाने के लिए बहुत सारे काम मेहनत किया है। कई जैसे कि हमारे यहाँ के ट्रांसपोर्ट कमेटी है, इनको तो दिन रात का कोई फर्क नहीं होता है, कोई भी हमारे अतिथि आते हैं तो उनको लेने के लिए जाना है, पहुँचाने के लिए जाना है, कई 4 बजे उठकर जाते हैं तो कई 11 बजे तक एयरपोर्ट या रेलवे स्टेशन पर रहना पड़ता है। इनमें मैं श्री पेमा छुंदे, श्री तेंजिंग केगे और छुंगदा, इसके साथ हमारे लोकल जो ट्रांसपोर्टेशन कमेटी है, प्रदीप कुमार, मुमताज, इन सब के मैं धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। आप लोगों के बिना ये कार्यक्रम इतना सफल नहीं हो पाएंगे। और इसके और सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट चीज़ कैटरिंग कमेटी है, जो विजय राजवाचार्य जी है, आपके टीम ने आप लोगों को बहुत स्वादिष्ट भोजन का परोसा है, सर्व किया है, और हम आशा करते हैं कि आप लोगों को हमारे जो भोजन जिन्होंने इन लोगों ने जो दिया है या जो परोसा है वो पसंद आया होगा। और इन सब के लिए मैं विजयराज जी और श्री डोलगर तेंजी रिगसंग दिगी डोलमा और श्री छुगी और लोसन थे इन सब का मैं तहे दिल से शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहूँगा। और इसके बाद हमारे जो लॉजिंग कमेटी है श्री टिंदे राम शास्त्री जी के इंचार्ज में तहत श्री गेशेगांव टेम्पल और ललित कुमार आप लोगों ने भी हमारे जो लॉजिंग को जो हमारे अतिथियों को कहाँ किस रूम में किसको रहना है किसको क्या करना है और रूम को किस तरह से क्या कहते हैं कि ऑर्गेनाइज करना है ये सब उन्होंने बहुत अच्छी तरह से किया है। उन सब के लिए मैं बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। और इसके बाद हमारे पब्लिक रिलेशन एंड रिपोर्टिया डॉक्टर रंजन कुमार शर्मा और डॉक्टर रवि गुप्ता मौर्य जो इन्होंने हमारे जो इस तीन दिन के एक सम्मेलन का या तीन दिन के जो संगोष्ठी का जो हमारे जो न्यूज़ चैनलों और न्यूज़ वालों को जो रिपोर्ट दिया है और उसकी वजह से आपने पहले दिन देखा होगा कि न्यूज़ में छापा है आए हैं ये न्यूज़ तो उन सब उन दोनों को भी मैं धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ। और इसके साथ अब बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट एक बात ये कमेटी है ऑडियो विजुअल एंड डॉक्यूमेंटेशन कमेटी जो आपके बीच में खड़े रहते हैं पूरे दिन और एक आप लोगों को पता शायद नहीं होगा कि पहले दिन का जो हमारे इनॉग्रेशन का जो सेशन था तो इनॉग्रेशन सेशन हम लोगों ने लाइव वेबकास्ट किया था तो उसको फेसबुक में हम लोगों ने किया था और आप लोगों के बदौलत वो संभव हुआ है। और आप लोग दिन रात सुबह से शाम तक आप लोग हम लोगों के बीच में खड़े रहकर ये सब कवर करते हैं तो इसी की और इसके बाद जो हमारे स्टूडेंट्स या कोई भी इंटरेस्टेड पर्सन जो इसको देखना चाहेंगे वो भी आप सबको मिलेगा और ये भी बाद में फिर यूट्यूब में डालते हैं तो कभी भी आप देख सकते हैं आप सुन सकते हैं फिर उसके ऊपर आप दोबारा विचार भी कर सकते हैं। तो इसलिए मैं इस कमेटी के जो तेंजिन थुयों जी है तेंजिन येशी है पलदिन सिरिंग है कलदिन गुरुंग है और तेंजिन छोमो सबको मैं बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। और जैसे कुलपति जी ने कहा कि हमारे गार्डनर मेंटेनेंस विंग को आपने धन्यवाद दिया था इन्होंने आपके सामने आप जो जिस हॉल में बैठे हैं हम इसकी पूरी सजावट के लिए इन्होंने पूरे तत्परता से काम किया है। यहाँ फूलों के सजाने से लेकर कुर्सी वगैरह जितना भी हमारे यहाँ जो वो काम है और रख रखाव साफ सफाई सब उन्होंने बड़ी अच्छी ढंग से किया है। उसके लिए मैं इंचार्ज कुंसन नामगेल जी और एक गोबिश और उनके सहयोगी जितना भी गार्डनर्स हैं गार्डन में काम करने वाले हैं सबको मैं धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। उसके बाद एक और इम्पोर्टेंट है फाइनेंस कमेटी जो आपके TA और DA डिस्पर्स करते हैं। अब इस कमेटी में सॉरी इस संगोष्ठी में इतने ज़्यादा लोग नहीं है इसलिए हमें कोई दिक्कत नहीं हुआ TA DA समय में देने में दिक्कत नहीं हुआ। अगर बड़े पैमाने पर होता था जब भी कॉलेज जुबले के समय तो बहुत सारे लोग आए थे तो हम लोगों को TA डिस्पर्स करने में बहुत ही समय लगा लेकिन इस बार बड़ी अच्छी ढंग से सब निपट गया। और मैं समझता हूँ आप सबको अपने अपने TA मिल गया होगा यदि नहीं मिला है तो मैं अभी दोबारा उसकी घोषणा करता हूँ कि आप लंच के समय शुक्ला जी वहाँ मिलेंगे आप उनसे संपर्क करके अपना TA और DA ले लें। और इसके लिए मैं शुक्ला जी को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। और उसके बाद जो सेमिनार किट्स कमेटी है जो आपके हाथ में जो बैग और पूरा किट्स एक साथ मिला है उसके श्रेय हम श्री गवा ज्ञानचंद नेगी जी और टी सिंह जी को देंगे। उन्होंने अपने पूरे समय निकाल करके समय में ये सब तैयार करने में पूरा अपना वो क्या कहते हैं कि काम किया है उनके लिए धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। और उसके बाद अंत में मल्टीमीडिया कमेटी जो आपके दाएं तरफ बैठे हैं श्री निरंकर पांडे और श्री अनिश जैन इन दोनों ने यहाँ की जो जैसे पहले दिन की वेबकास्टिंग के लिए जो भी इंटरनेट वगैरह का जो भी व्यवस्था करना होगा वो करना होता है, वो और आपकी एवी सिस्टम जितना भी है वो सब इन्होंने किया है, उसके लिए मैं बहुत बहुत उन दोनों को धन्यवाद देना चाहता हूँ। और हमारे यहाँ के जो पीए सिस्टम के काम करने वाले श्री सुभाष का भी धन्यवाद दूंगा, क्योंकि उनके बदौलत अब हम यहाँ से वहाँ तक ऊंची आवाज़ में बोलने की ज़रूरत नहीं पड़ता है, पीए सिस्टम अच्छी तरह से काम करते हैं, उसके लिए उन्होंने मेहनत किया है, उसके लिए मैं उनका धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा। बस इतनी शब्दों के साथ अब समय भी बहुत हो गया है, तो इसलिए मैं यहीं अपना क्या कहते हैं ये दायित्व यहीं पर समाप्त करता हूँ। और एक बात, यदि आज आप लोग शाम को जाने वाले जितने भी लोग हैं शाम को निकलने वाले हों तो वो ज़रूर हमारे जो ट्रांसपोर्ट कमेटी से आपको ज़रूर इन्फॉर्म कर दीजिएगा, वो लोग आपके लिए गाड़ी और जो भी हो व्यवस्था कर लेंगे। धन्यवाद, थैंक यू सो मच।